Hello children, today in this video we will discuss about some rights and duties which we should follow as a citizens of India. Our rights, duties and responsibilities should go hand in hand. So first of all, I will tell you about the Constitution of India. It is the supreme law of India and it lays down the framework of some principles, powers and duties of government institutions and sets our fundamental rights, principles and the duties of citizens. And it is the longest written constitution of any sovereign country in the world. It is written in English and then it has been translated into Hindi. It was passed on November 26, 1949 and came into effect on January 26, 1950. And since then we celebrate 26 January as the Republic Day. It was framed by a committee of 8 members headed by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who is widely regarded as the father of Indian Constitution. Now children, why should we know our rights? What are rights? Rights literally means the freedom which are essential for the good of an individual as well as the community. Our Constitution provides certain fundamental rights to all the citizens of India, and some of them are right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, right to constitutional remedy. We will discuss these rights one by one. Now our first fundamental right is right to equality. Right to equality means equality in the eyes of law, whether it's of any caste, creed, religion, place of birth, etc. All human beings are born free and they have equal rights and duties. Now our next fundamental right is right to freedom. We have right to freedom of speech and expression, to move freely throughout the territory of India, to reside and settle in any of territory of India, and freedom to practice any profession and to follow any religion. Our next right is right against exploitation. The Constitution forbids exploitation of people by others. It means no person can be forced to do any work against his or her will. And under this right, employment of children less than 14 years of age, human trafficking and forced labors, these are considered offense in our country. Our next fundamental right is right to freedom of religion. Every citizen has the right to follow any religion and visit any place of worship. All religions are given equal importance in India. Our next right is cultural and educational rights. As India is a country of many languages, religions and cultures, people are given the right to follow their own culture and language and to run educational institutions. There is a right of children to free and compulsory education, provides free and compulsory education for all children till the age of 14 years. Our last right is right to constitutional remedies. This right allows citizens to approach a high court or the Supreme Court if they believe that any of their fundamental rights have been denied, and the courts can issue orders and direct the government to restore the rights of the citizens. Apart from the fundamental rights given by the Constitution of India, it has given a set of duties also which all of us have to perform, and these are called fundamental duties. Now we will discuss fundamental duties one by one. Every Indian citizen must follow the ideals given in the Constitution. It is the duty of every citizen to respect the national flag and national anthem. The people of the country must protect the unity and integrity of the nation. As a citizen of our country, we must defend our country and serve it when it needed. We must promote the spirit of brotherhood among the people. All citizens of India must be treated equally by us. We should value and preserve the rich heritage of our country. We should take care of the environment. We should develop the scientific temper and the spirit of inquiry and reform. We should take care of the public property. We should not harm or hurt anyone and help the government when the country is in danger. I hope you all understood that fundamental rights and duties are of no use until we use our rights for the betterment of our society. Only written things are of no use until we make it in our practice. And it's time we leave our differences behind, come together and fight for things that are fundamentally right. Let's show them our strength in numbers and solidarity. The revolution can happen. Thank you, children, for listening this video. I hope you understand all the concepts we discussed in the video.